We are solving some of the important questions of the GATE model questions that have been given in the HSS section, that is Humanities and Social Sciences, for your aptitude 2021. Now note that the questions that have been given in the model paper 2021 are much more simpler than the 2020 actual exam aptitude questions which we have covered in a separate lecture. The idea is probably for this aptitude, which is for social sciences, you can have a little simpler questions, but you must go through the 2020 paper that we have covered separately because the level of question is significantly different. Now here, while I agree to his proposal this time, I do not often agree with him. So we agree with a person, okay? But we can either agree to a proposal or agree with a proposal. So when I say to a proposal or with a proposal, what is a major difference? When I say to a proposal, that means it's my involvement and my acceptance to whatever you are suggesting. When I say I agree with the proposal, it basically means I am trying to understand it, comprehend it, and signal whether it sounds good to me or not, and then only I am going to accept or not. So both of these usage are technically correct, but most common usage we would say is to here. So I agree to his proposal and I agree with him would be the right options. The next is the recent measures to improve the outcome increases the level of production to our satisfaction. So the recent measures to improve the output. So I am trying to improve the output or the outcome, and for that I am trying to increase the level of production to our satisfaction, and then only the improvement in the outcome can be seen. So increase would be the right option. Now when we are using white, it causes whitening, so it is whitening, and with light, it is lightening, that is making it brighter. So you have lightening as the right option. So it's a direct question on analogy that is there. Now this is an interesting question. It's about a cricket match, but what are the words being used are important. So Ben Stokes upped the tempo. Up the tempo means increase the enthusiasm. So up means increase, tempo means enthusiasm, okay, for a 5.5 year long stay of 219 balls with 11 fours and 8 sixes that saw him finish, that resulted him to finish how many runs, and it was 135 runs with not out, still he was not out, as England squared the fifth match series. So he conquered, England conquered the fifth match series, okay. So tempo means enthusiasm, saw means resulted in, upped means increased, squared means not lost but conquered. So B does not match. So the question says which does not match. The answer would be B does not match here. The next question is pretty interesting. Now understand it. At each level, okay, the price of the product is increased by 25%. If the product is produced at P at a cost of 120 per unit. So when it comes from P to Q, it is, sorry, from P to Q, it is 120 rupees. Okay, now here you have 25% increase in the cost. So 25% of 120, so 120 into 1 by 4, that is 30. I add 30 to 120, that makes it 150. So on this line, it becomes 150. Now again, I increase it by 25%. So 150, 1/4 of 150. So 25% is 25 by 100, and therefore I'm using 25 by 100, which is 1 by 4. So I do 1 by 4th of 150, which is 37.5. I add 37.5 to 150. This gives me 187.5. So from R to S, it becomes 187.5. Again on this, I have a 25% increase. So 187.5, 1/4 of it. This gives me 46.8. something, so whatever it is, okay, then I add 46.87 with 187.5, which gives me 234.37, okay, so this arrow becomes 234.37. Now again there is a 25% increase, so 25% of 234.37, that is 1/4 of it, okay, I do 1/4 of it. Now this comes out to be 58.59, okay? So I add this 58.59 with 234.37 giving me 292.96. So this value when it goes to customer is 292.96. So B becomes my right option. Now a lot of students got confused here as to till what level we would move, okay? So what you need to understand is you have to mark the values on the arrow. Okay, so count the number of arrows and mark the values accordingly. The first value is 120 and do a compounding of it. So 25% of 120 and then whatever value you get, 25% of it, add it to again the base value and then move forward. And finally, the last arrow would be your answer. Okay, the next question is very, very simple, very, very interesting. Climate change and resilience deal with two aspects. Reduction of the source of non-renewable energy sources, that is fossil fuels, simply put, to avoid any complicated language, and reduce the vulnerability of climate change. So we use mitigation and adaptation. Mitigation is where we are trying to deal with the actions to reduce the use of fossil fuels, that is correct, okay? And adaptation is once it has already happened, we try to adapt ourselves. So adaptation deals with causes, no. It deals with the action to combat, no. Combat means to again do something, so it is mitigation, okay? And mitigation deals with the consequence of climate change, no. So it clearly says reduction of sources of non-renewable energy resource, that is reducing the use of fossil fuel. So A becomes the right option. This is a very interesting question. To solve this, I simply write A to Z in a circle, G I J K L M N O P Q R S T U V W X Y and Z. Now I have N in the middle. Okay, so I circle N. From N, I have H and T. So I move here 5 points and I have H. I move here 5 points and I have T. And therefore it is 5 given here. Okay, in the next case, it is 9 given here and it is X. So I move 9 points. So 5 points is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5 gap. So here it is 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, then 6, 7, 8 and 9. Okay, so you have X. So I leave 3 more here, I leave 3 more here and it is D here. So here it would be D. So from N, if I'm moving 5 points, I would get T and H. Simple as that. From N, I move 5 points, I get T and H. From N, I move 9 points, I get D and X. So answer would be D. A very, very simple and a direct question. The next is, this is an estimate that 52 men can complete a work in 10 days. So one work would be done in how many days? So 52 into 10 would be one person, one day work. Okay. Now, due to an emergency, 12 men were sent to another project. So if I want to calculate the work done by one person in one day, it would be 1 by 52 into 100, that is 1 by 520. Now 12 person went in an emergency, so how many left? 40. So I simply do 520 divided by 40, so this gives me 13. But my answer is not here over. It says how many number of days more than the original estimate would be required to complete. So total number of days required would be 13. Definitely when there are less people, more number of days. So when there were 52 people, 10 days were sufficient. When there are 40 people, I'll require 13 days. But the question says how many more than the original estimate. So original estimate was 10. How many more? 3 days more. So here answer will not be 13. It would be 3. Be very, very particular about questions like this, and this is something that you must and must know while solving the question. Read the question very, very carefully. The next is, an engineer measures three quantities X, Y and Z in an experiment. She founds that there is a relationship such that X and Y have a relationship with Z. Now, which of the statement is false? The relation between X, Y and Z is a constant relationship, that is correct, because it's a linear line that is there. So it's a constant relationship, that is correct. If I keep my X fixed, I would say Z is proportional to Y, that is correct. If I keep my Y fixed, I can say Z is proportional to X, that is again correct. But if I keep my Z fixed, I cannot say that X is proportional to Y, that would be false, because It could be in any ratio. It could be squared. It could be a fraction. I cannot predict about that. So the only incorrect choice here would be D, that is for a fixed value of Z. I cannot say X and Y are proportional. The next and the last question here, there are two pie charts. Okay. I have the total number of students that are 5000, total number of girls enrolled that are 1500. Now, the question says you have to find the ratio of boys enrolled in arts to the girls enrolled in management. So first of all, I take the girls enrolled in management. So that is very simple. 15% is management. So 15% of 1500 by 100, that so 15%, so 15 by 100 of 1500, that gives me 225. So 225 is the ratio of girls. Now I have to find out the ratio of boys in arts. So in the arts, total number of students are how many? 5000. 5000 out of that 20% are in arts. So I have 1000 students in arts. And when it comes to girls, I have 30% girls in arts. So how many girls? 1500 girls, 30% of 1500, that is 450 girls. So how many boys? 550 boys. Okay, 1000. I would have 1000 is the total number of students in arts minus 450, which are the girls. So how many boys? 550 are the boys. Now, if I remove this, I have 550 boys in arts versus 225 girls in management. So the ratio would be 550 is to 225, that is 2:1. So 2:1 would be the right option. Very, very simple question. So if we see the pattern, moreover, first three questions are related from English comprehension and English reading, first four questions. Then last question definitely based on graphs, pie charts, one, two intermediate questions based on ratio proportionality or based on matrices, as we have seen in 2020 paper, which we have covered. I repeat again, 2020 actual paper, the questions in the aptitude were much more difficult than what has been given in the model paper. So be ready for a little difficult questions. We have covered 2020 paper in a separate class. So just go through that. A lot of questions were conceptual, and if you are able to answer those, you are all set for your paper. And you can follow the links below for the complete paper and the description. Have a wonderful day.